Buddies, Paul Roberts, artsy one here. Another video on belts. And I'm gonna put this to bed. No more belts. At least for a while. This is mostly gonna be about why I don't do belts. You think I do belts more than anything, right? Just for you guys on the video. Why do I not do belts? It's very simple, folks. The pie is too fragmented. I can't do it and have it be a part of my hobby because it isn't worth my time. So what belts used to be was like this, okay? Urethane. And you take this very expensive, what is now very expensive urethane, and you take and put metal particles in there just right, different colored urethane just right, very expensive, and then pull it out and it's done if it's done properly. That type of a thing won't even yield the cost to make it. That's why I don't do it. That's why it's come down to me and you, bad buddies. That's why we make belts and show you how to do it. It's gotten to the point where that's really what it's gotta be. I've got a couple of parts ready for a nice buckle. I thought I'd stack these. Look at that. This is equivalent to just one pour. I don't know why I didn't think of that before. This is too clunky. I'm gonna try to find something leaner. I'm probably not gonna do all this today. A belt like this, pure solid latex, takes over a week, sometimes 2 weeks to produce. And that's if I babysit it. Latex is not meant to be thick, but you can make it thick if you're a latex pro. So why do I do these? Same reason I do these. Because whenever I'm done with a pour, or whenever I'm doing something with latex and there's a little left over, it's very easy to go ahead and fill this in just a little at a time if you're very, very patient. I do them maybe a couple times a year. And because we're talking about belts and wanting to put this belt thing to bed for a while, I thought I'd just pull these out and show you a few things, kind of generically, because it would take me too long to do all of this in one video. So what should I do today? Since I talked to you about what it takes to do one of these properly and expensively, let's talk to you about what it takes to do it another way. This, like I said, is already time consuming to get it to this point. Latex is going way through the roof, but that's it. There's no other cost involved. Now, if I can put this together quickly and help a bat buddy out and cover my costs and the worthwhile time doing it, then it's worth doing. And if I can't, I won't touch it again for a long time, and usually I don't. But today, I'm just gonna go through this with you all to show you what the options are. And one of the reasons why I work like I do now is because there's so many people that are just flamboyantly just pop, 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 popping everything out. It's changed the world as we know it. I've made some changes to the way I do things. I'm in a different stage in my life anyway. What I do for something like this, let me just take this begins belt, because we've done this recently on a junkie belt to show you how to restore a junkie belt to acceptable quality. This is pretty good. I won't do that again. And then this is pretty much usually always black, maybe with a little bit of rustic silver tone to give it kind of a feel of more standing out in the suit, but not totally being gold or silver. But this has a life of its own. I could go and make this look like the real deal, all nice and new. But let's remember, he could have a new one. What did they order, like 1,000 of those cowls in the graphite? He could have a new one every time he goes out, right? But let's say another Batman doesn't have a new one every time he goes out. Let's say he goes down another path, the alternate DC universe. He goes down another path, he doesn't have a lot of money. Then this makes it within the realm of where we can do it quickly and inexpensively, and maybe help a bat buddy out or have something for our costume that we like. So let's talk about what it takes to do this quickly and to the point where you could still make it worth your time to go through the process if you wanted to. Let's exclude the idea that we had to have the original, we had to have the mold. Let's exclude the idea we babysat it for weeks. Let's just assume that you have this in your hands. Sometimes I do let go of things that are imperfect and they're latex, and I say, hey, make it your own. Basically, what I'm trying to do there is just cover my costs of the material itself. So let's start this out the right way and go up top and show you what to do. Just wish I had a can of Plasti-Dip. It goes so fast around here. Yeah, I could reach for my archived Plasti-Dip that I decided to keep, Eric's 20-something-year-old Plasti-Dip forever. I'm not going to use it, even though I used it on the video the other day. It's just too important. And I just get so tired of going down to Home Depot and getting Plasti-Dip. I just wish I could just pull it out of my ear. Oh, yeah, that works. Okay. So the first thing we did, let's go up top. So I've done it before. I'm going to kind of just talk about things today because there's not much to this. I'll talk to you about things
talked to some of my bat buddies recently, and they say I should just have the strength and courage to do what I want to do and not worry about what everybody says I should do, because I don't have a large enough audience, which is fine, but the people that do come are very interested, which is great. Do or do not, there is no try. Obviously, I can do this till the end of time. That's not an issue. But on this channel, I'm trying to show you some things that I don't normally do, so that it's not like what I'm showing that I normally do. I don't show what I normally do, unless I do a What's on the Desk series and I got a bunch of oddball odds and ends. So there you have that, okay? The very first thing we're gonna do is, remember, I'm using non-conventional materials. I can't afford skin flex. I can't afford expensive metal. I could for my own stuff, but if I'm gonna share this with any other bat buddy, absolutely not. So the first thing I do is say, okay, well, what can I work with? I can work with what I've got. Inexpensive spray paint available to everyone. And worn, not necessarily battle damaged, but worn looks. Because if you go lightly, it doesn't matter. You're using a non-stretchy, inappropriate paint. And that's how we can get by and produce something versus nothing for very little cost. So by the time you've got your materials in it, by the time you got your efforts to originally come up with it, by the time you've taken and processed everything, talk to your bat buddy, find out what he wants, come over here and get in the studio, you don't have a whole lot of time left to do anything if it's going to be worth your while to do it. So we do the spritz, the holding hands of the particles. The wear is still on there, but this equalizes it. I stop spraying when I think it's equalized enough. That, to me, looks like something very well used by Batman and made to look like that, but not ruined. There you go. But that's not all. These are supposed to be silver. Some of this is supposed to be black. Okay, that works. And you don't have to worry about it being perfect. I painted outside the line right there. Hang on. Age the edge a little bit. I'll say we're going to put that same amount on all the edges. You know, if you're a musician and you do something wrong, just do it twice. Same thing with an artist. All of a sudden, it's not wrong, it's just offbeat. Yeah, you meant to do that. Now listen, I want to emphasize something that I don't talk about very often, and that is, this is not the way that I've always worked. This is the way that I'm working now. And that little talk I did in the beginning kind of tells you about the necessitation of this. So I wanted to have this be, since it's a mundane experience, a little bit more of me talking to you bat buddies and telling you where I came from and why I don't work like this. I don't work like this because, let's face it, this is a hobby, but when you stay in this for as long as I do, eventually you're going to have it be where the hobby is worth you staying in it, at least on some level. I use it as a creative outlet. I'd like to continue to use it as a creative outlet because it makes me happy. It's a nice addition to my life. It makes me meet and talk with great people like you bat buddies and others that I've known for a long, long time. Even if they come and go and they're just acquaintances, I had a good time with them while I was acquainting with them. And they do pop back in and say hi every now and then. And they do consider these new kind of internet friendships, friendships. And I like people that at least do that. And I reach out and I say, do that, because I'm going to do it back. So you have my assurity. But I'm not going to go around social media and go looking for you. Now I'm going to go in with the splashy dip and do the black part, because I can. Might as well. I keep reaching over there for the Q-tips and they're right here. You know, I haven't looked at this for so long, I forget what colors are what, but it doesn't matter. I'm going to let this go to a bat buddy that wants to work on a project that's not perfect. And if he wants a different color, he'll just take some of these techniques and do it himself. It's come down to that, guys. It's really come down to that. The movies are so successful. It's just like the 501st Star Wars. They don't want to be raining on your parade because you're a fan. And a little bit of going around and dressing up in costume and everything actually helps them with their cause to generate publicity for their movies. I mean, not that they need it. They're doing well enough anyway. But I've always felt that if we just don't abuse anybody, treat everybody the way we'd want to be treated, you know, observe the highest commandment, I've always felt that that will be seen and understood and observed by others and would allow us some longevity And each one of us real serious bat fans on the planet that aren't just saying that, but really are. All of us really serious bat fans on the planet, like me, since I was riding my big wheel, deserve something for our support. And what I deserve is just simply to let well enough alone and just have a life and kind of take it seriously and teach others to care about what they're thinking about as they go along. I got this attitude way back. Gosh, I got more to say, and I'm pretty much done. I got this attitude really way back in the beginning of the Brotherhood of the Bat Boards, and seeing everybody argue. I don't know what these are, but I just think they should use a little flare of color. And I saw the negativity of everyone come out, channel just in the Batman arena. This was before Facebook. And I got a chance to really see what people are like for the first time. And that's when I started thinking about conscious counseling. I first talked to them live, trying to bring out the good in people. I don't know if I was successful. There were some lousy people on some of those boards. Just a few. We know who they are if we're big fans of the boards. But then that led to the idea that I can see who's out there now. I'm world renowned for a bat buddy. Got to see the world outside my cave for the first time. And when I did that, that was when I first put my costume on for the first time and started to become that hero for the first time. Started to dawn on me that's what I was meant to do. So when I dress in my costume, my act is conscious counseling. My act is trying to go out into the world and help people be positive and conscious and aware that everything they are, whether they're wearing a costume or not, is what makes this world up. Well, that's just a symbol, right? Because I don't really wear this. But behind the mask is what I really do.
This isn't me. I'm not Batman.
I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. That is why this place is called Behind the Mask. All this stuff is irrelevant. It's just a means to an end. It's another thing. And one of the reasons I do this is because I have something worthwhile to say. I can actually affect this world in a positive way, and so can you. And I want people that realize that to be a part of this group. Let me just finish this up and go back out front. I just check out my edges, make sure they're okay. A little Krylon Crystal Clear will ensure an even finish, and it'll ensure that you're protecting what you've done from coming off very easily. And this is acrylic, so it will flex just a little bit. I can go a little heavier than I did with the paint. And there we have a belt, but took a lot more than that. And there's expense in it too. It doesn't matter what I get for it, because I'm not hurt that badly. Especially if I'm not doing this on a regular basis, maybe 2 a year. This one's done for this purpose. I pulled this out just for you guys. Let's go out front. And that doesn't even include the pouches. If you do the pouches, you gotta spend a lot of time on those too. Now, you've seen me do this before. I probably haven't done one of these in, I'd say, over a year. Just not worth it. I pulled this out, put this together, and did this little talk just for you guys. I wanna finish up my Bat Utility Belt series here and move on to some other things. We've had this little talk. You've seen me put this together really quickly, and you get efficient, and you work on several things at a time. Eventually, you can make a little bit over your material costs. That's why I don't do belts very often. But I wanted to share this with you today, so I pulled it out and I said, okay, I'll do one for the guys. That's how that's done. I'm gonna fool around with these. I might do it on video, but I did say this is the end of the belt. I don't know how I'm gonna feel, but it's nice having you guys here. It's nice having you guys interested, but I may very well start doing other things that aren't bat related. So don't shoot me. Hopefully you'll stick around just because I'm me and the way I do things applies to everything I do. You saw that little news clip about the rocks. I'm like that about everything in my life. Not just here. I had to take a break today while I was editing this video, so I had time to let some other videos process, and I had time to finish these. Somebody asked me to put my costume on, and so I did. I talked to them. I gave what I had from inside, behind my mask, behind my costume. So let's finish up for today and show you what I've done. So anyway, Bat Buddies, I'll just say goodbye for now. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. I don't know what I'm going to do next, but I'm going to shut it down before it starts getting hot right now. And I'm going to take a little break from belts. Yeah, that's enough.